Hey guys, Broker Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Marseille career mode where last time I left off. If I made freaking history, yeah, oh, if you don't know what I'm talking about, go and watch yesterday's episode. It was freaking brilliant. In this episode, I have quite possibly the most crucial match of the season so far. I am facing second place Saint Etienne. Which means this is my chance to go 10 points clear at the top of the table. Now, I've already faced PSG this career mode, and I beat them, and they were in second at the time. So, oh, this game is worrying me a little bit because I'm still waiting for a team to score against me, because no team has. And I'm still anticipating which team will get the bullshit draw against me. That's very good defense. I know it's November, but it's the end of November. Ramat Hamouma.
Two players there with a strong tackle between them.
I'm a little worried that this might be in my December draw, only a bit early.
Clément.
Hopefully it's not. I'm going to go all out. Hopefully. Yes. Oh, Batshuayi, you prick. Why did you hit it straight at the keeper? That was like a brilliant starting opportunity. There's Hakan Çalhanoğlu.
To produce something special to break through this defense.
Oh, what a move. Tovan. Still Tovan. No. How many defenders do they have? Yo, they have everyone back. 9:20 minutes into this match and they're on fucking park the bus. Yes. Oh, yes, surely. No, what's? Oh, he's offside. Oh, for fuck's sake. Damn it, Batshuayi, yes. Let's make it up. No, he hit the post again! Are you freaking kidding me? He missed! Oh my god, this is gonna be the match. It is! This is gonna be the match with the bullshit. It draw, it's gonna be nil-nil. This game's up. No. No, no, no.
You know what, at the end of it, we could have seen quite a few goals here.
Back it goes to the back of his heel.
Yes, good job, Mendy. Batshuayi, you pass it off immediately. I've lost complete faith in you in this match. Çalhanoğlu, who, yes! First time asking from someone other than Batshuayi, and they put it away. Yes!
And that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Say it to you. And 22 minutes of luck ran up. Or out, or however. You get what I'm saying. Yeah, I'm definitely not giving the ball to you, Batshuayi. If it wasn't so early in the match, I would sub you off.
The goalkeeper with a textbook save and keeps the ball in his grasp.
Enkidu. Oh!
Well, it's a penalty.
Penalty! I'm not sure what he's given a penalty for. I mean, I saw Batshuayi go down, but the defender is in the way. Çalhanoğlu, chance to make it 2-0, buries it. Yo, they're not gonna get a bullshit draw. Ciao. Logo, who is going to send them home with their tails tucked between their leg.
And here's the goal again.
This is brilliant. And for the record, I'm not giving Batshuayi any credit even for winning that penalty. That makes up for...
And he gives it back to his teammate.
For hitting the post. Most anyone can hit the post, but... He'll have to score a damn hat-trick in this match to make up for that bizarre miss. I know it's 2-0 already, but...
Benjamin Mendy.
It's 2-0. Also, that miss didn't really affect. Does. But still. It's a matter of principle, and the fact that he should have scored that goal.
Lost his footing.
Especially considering he's supposed to be our main striker.
No goal. Flag up.
Well, that assistant there, he was certain the flag went up straight away.
Press the wrong button.
They've got into score here.
It didn't affect it. Enkidu still scored.
It was a great race, a great pace, and a fantastic goal.
Well, how quickly did they go from back to front there? What a counter-attack.
3-0. That's his first goal.
See this, such a one-sided first half.
Weirdly enough.
Got going the opposition, and they're surely...
He's been mostly getting the assists, but... He's gotten his name finally on the score sheet.
Mendy. Batshuayi. Clément. Clément. Well, that's a good challenge between the two of them there.
And there is the half time. Team whistle, PSG are being Lorient. That would put them level on points with it, Saint-Étienne, but the goal difference still hasn't turned around enough in PSG's favor. They need to score at least, there still needs to be two more goals in either one of the games. Because the gap was before this game. These games, 5 goals. Well, Saint-Étienne had 5 goals more as well as 3 points more. So, as it stands, PSG, are 2 more goals in there for them, so they finished 3-0 as well, or 2 goals for me, so I finished 5-0, or 1 in each, so they finished 2-0 and I finished 4-0. I can't guarantee a second and a half goal, or if there is one, it'll only be 1, maybe 2 if we're lucky.
Victory kick.
It's looking like PSG will be going back into second place. Play on.
Put it in well.
Chalogu. Oh, that was a piss poor header.
Another. This went straight at the goalkeeper. Saw that pass coming in midfield. Made the intervention, and now maybe he can. Referee sees that.
Good challenge.
A foul, and it is
what?
Free.
Come on, referee. You stupid idiot.
For Saint-Étienne.
Well, one or two shots to speak of, but not many to talk about in glowing terms here.
Whoops. Now that was definitely a foul. Yeah, no surprise to see the yellow come out.
Yellow for Nkulu.
Great defending.
Tabanou. These two have got a great understanding with their
passing. I well placed my man on the line.
Hamouma. Stephen Fletcher.
Now go. Hit the counter. Hit the counter. Yes. Cholo goes away. Hey, for the hat trick. Bury it.
Oh. By the keeper.
Second time I'm asking. It is for nil. PSG are going back into second. But the gap will still be 10 points. So either way, hooray! And I was worried that they were going to get a bullshit.
Having scored two, he was just so full of confidence and he never looked like missing that chance.
Draw, but no bullshit draw for you, St. Etienne.
But look at the scoreline.
Like I said, it ain't gonna happen in this year's in this career mode.
Would be one of the tightest games we've seen.
The run finally ends.
The other way. Yeah, it has. It has. I think everybody in the stadium was quite surprised by that, because one side has been knocking the ball.
Drawing with the team who will inevitably finish second in December isn't gonna happen, because the two teams fighting for second have both been ruthlessly dispatched.
Mendy. He's cut out the pass, intercepting if you like, and now can go on the attack maybe. Gregory van der Veel. And that pass, just subtle little clip pass in really. This could be a
try.
He's got his shot off now.
Oh my god, he missed again. He missed again. John Logan was really tired, so I'm going to have to take him off for Alessandrini. Why not?
Up there.
Near complaining. Near complaining.
Good position. He's going to come off the attacking midfield.
Sir, attacking mid, but
They've obviously feel he's done his job. He was good.
Oh, he was good, extremely good, and he'll be watching the highlights tonight, I'm sure, because he was star man for me.
They're thinking of a substitution, I think, Saint-Étienne. Well, the home team has been outplayed, and the home supporters. Oh, he's through. Now the shot.
It doesn't really matter at this point.
The ball is his, and he's made sure he's protected it. That's the way to win the ball back. Théophile Catherine. Lemoine. Well, they're building steadily here, working away. Giving the opposition a problem with their interpassing. Gregory van der Veel. Stop the game for the free kick. His job is to sit in front of the back four and really help the defence, but it's not been that kind of game, has it? And he's been moved around a bit. He's off now, anyway.
Well, he has. I mean, the opposition, in fairness, have played really well. And
unfortunately, Chalago's gone off, so let's see what Alex Sadri can do. He almost scored.
Now it's a corner.
He got the shot on target, at least. And the free kick. There they are. Ooh.
Looking to take the corner quickly. Diarra. What a
no header. And none. Or punch clearance.
Well, it's a massive margin of victory here. That victory confirmed by the final whistle. 4-0, the final score. Well,
Lawrence scored a goal, so PSG will be level on goal difference with Saint-Étienne. I don't know if that puts them into second place or not.
Guingamp 1, Toulouse 0. Lorient 1.
Ooh, the tension.
Two. Montpellier 0.
I said tension. I'm just going to check right now.
Bastia 2. GFC Ajaccio 1.
Tables.
Rennes 1. Bordeaux 1. Let's have a look at what those results mean for tonight's league tables. At the top of the table remain Olympique Marseille.
No, Saint-Étienne are still in.
In second, Saint-Étienne with 32 points.
In, third, in second place,
Paris Saint-Germain with 32.
Probably because they have more goals scored than PSG.
In fifth, Bordeaux with 24 points. In sixth,
I'm going to assume that's why they are second.
With 20 points.
Not that it matters, it's 10 points to both of them, and they're both falling behind.
With 18 points. Bottom of the table, Troy with 8 points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Angers with 9 points. Third bottom, GFC Ajaccio with 10 points. Fourth bottom, Toulouse with 10 points. Fifth bottom and falling are Caen with 13 points.
Right. Sorry about that. I was just checking something. I'm professional, I know, but real life comes first, ladies and gentlemen. Real life, it does indeed come first. Shit. Good. Could be okay. Terrible. 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 Absolutely terrible. Because I have main squad players on the bench, so in case they come out and get injured, that's why I saved the game. No other particular reason. The results shouldn't matter. 2-1 Sparanga got injured, but he's not a main team player. That should mean Sampdoria will go all out for 5 months.
Ajax,
yo,
Borussia Dortmund.
Damn.
Augsburg 1, Napoli 2.
Wow.
Legia Warsaw 0, Bordeaux.
What
two.
A
Liga
kick
Bayern,
to the
two,
teeth Nantes that two. Has got to be. That should mean Sampdoria went back above me. And I'm not going to count that as a team scoring against me because technically I didn't play that match. No, I'm still top of the group. Oh, they drew with Gothenburg. Gothenburg got their first points. What? How does that work? As long as I don't lose to Sampdoria, I should be fine. I don't know who's going to play in this second team instead of your man. Like, the only option is this random 58 rated at center back. Like, I could look on the free agents and see if there is one for the second team. Oh, and before I forget, there we go. Just so I don't forget. more. Leave me alone. So many options. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look on the free agents list as soon as I end the video. PSG have gone back into second place. Good for them. You know, good for them. I don't give a crap. I've already beaten PSG, so by the time they play me the second time, I'll be near hearing my league victory. Depending on when it is. Not sure when that second game against PSG is, but I know for a fact it won't be in December. I'll still be on the lookout for. I'm still waiting for a team to. That one's new. I don't think I've seen that skill game before.
Marking your card, really, as we try to do. Main man for Marseille.
Oh, yeah, look.
Here he is. Oh, been in fine form. In front of goal. Top
Patrick
in
the last
12.
Game puts him above Bashawai, who's lucky to even be playing in this match.
Looking to continue his great form in midfield. And they've got plenty of goals.
Any more bad performances like that last match in
Daniel Subasic starts in goal. Elderson
Ben Yedder might not it's a quick break. Be our second team and replace me, and he might be Bashawai's replacement. Of course, there is still the possibility that Chelsea might come in for Bashawai anyway come January. Who knows? As Tovan opens the scoring. Four goals for him now this season. Nice early goal as well. Oh, the good joys.
Well, he's pressed him there to running the ball out of play. And in it comes quickly with a throw in.
Yo.
Well, it could be in.
Fletcher's in the middle. Is he onside? He missed anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered. No, he was onside. Unless they get no, it would have given the it would have given the offside first if he had been offside. So yeah, that was just a bad miss, Stephen.
This home team have been unconquerable, home or away. A massive run that they're on, and just want to keep it going today.
Well, you look through at the
Mendy looking for the cross. Bashawai is beaten. Into it. It's Chan. Who?
Well, it is a free kick.
Who gets the free kick? I couldn't get the shot away before the referee gave the free kick against Marseille. I mean, against Monaco. Ugh! King, I'm confused. Yo, look at the size of that guy, Ian, though. All compared to the other. Yes! Ha ha! I scored a free kick in this career mode.
Two keepers gonna stop that one.
That's four, and that's two on camera as well. Oh, I knew I'd score one with Chanelog who before the end this career mode. And their big ass, this bastard in the wall couldn't do anything except make a shitty matrix move. Oof, like. If he was in the Matrix, he would have gotten shot. well done, Chalogu. I knew I'd get one with him. And his free kicks were just too high for it not to happen at some point. I knew it would happen eventually. There we go. Four free kicks. Yo, I'm going to have to play with Chan. Use Chanelogu in more of my career modes when I'm needing of a free kick taker.
Throw for Marseille. This is the sort of side with the credentials to win the league. And they're getting themselves in a good position to do that.
They are. I mean, they've not been phased at all by being top. Sometimes it can affect.
And here's the shot. Useful block in those.
And I bet. Hello. I bet Monaco will think twice about giving away sloppy free kicks in the in dangerous areas now. Should always be wary of that, but
the away team come here, drawn their last two,
emphasizes that fact that you should never give away free kicks, especially if you No, your opponent have a deadly free kick taker. I mean, Chanelogu has to have one of the best free kick stats in the game. I mean,
well, the pitch not quite wide enough for him there.
I don't know if his are the best. I don't know everyone's off by heart.
The break is definitely on.
But he's definitely in the top 5, if not the top 10.
Until that defender acted very promptly and decisively.
Well, his are 90 something. I think it's 6. It might be higher than that. You know what? I'm actually going to get full confirmation. Free kicks are 94. Yo, they're down from last year. They're down from last FIFA. What the hell? How has he gotten worse at them? 94, I'm pretty sure that's lower in Ronaldo's, which is 95? Or am I thinking of his actual rating? No, I think his free kicks are rated 95 out of 99. I would say 100, but you can't have a stat 100.
This could be a chance.
99 is the highest you can have. Oh, he avoids the chance. And Tova. And. Oh, that shot was piss. For the power.
2 minutes left. That's added time.
Chalgu. Not sure why I went for it.
Unlucky because he got some power behind the ball, just not the direction.
I'm still buzzing. You know what the title of this video is going to be. Well, of course you
might be through.
I often forget that you're not watching this live.
Fine save. He's had a go here. Off the crossbar. And back into the penalty area.
And Kadu. Oh, you.
The goalkeeper at full stretch.
Son of.
Coming up now, a corner.
Traore, that's the big guy who was in the wall. Should have recognized it was him. Well, in any event. Toulon will feel very. He disappointed himself at the halftime in break because that second goal is all on him.
They've got the second half to contend with now. And it's Fletcher. There goes the cross. And it's a headed effort at goal.
Tovan! Oh, another goal for Tovan. A Tovan brace.
A header that was. Top left hand corner, couldn't really have done it anyway.
Fletcher kept the ball after the challenge in Tova. And we're very nice. Placed it into the top corner of the net. I mean, he couldn't have placed it better unless he picked it up and put it in himself. Of course, he couldn't do that. That would be impossible. Or he'd be penalized immediately for randomly picking up the ball.
Substitution around the corner, I think, for Monaco. Toulalon. Ricardo Cavallo. Your diary, EA Sports covering the Ligue 1 fixture.
Information on my next game.
I'll be facing Rennes away
from
home.
First game of the next
episode. It should be a decent game, this, given the players on view.
Batshuayi.
Been pretty. Yeah, it's been damn near anonymous in this match. The hell? Where's, the Abbey? Where the hell's, where's Alessandrini? Alessandrini's supposed to be here where the Abbey is. The hell? I'll have to fix that. Not sure. I didn't move him. What the hell? I mean, and he didn't. He's not the one who got injured. It was Sangaria. Who's a defender? Her in the second team. What? What kind of bullshit is this? Nothing happened to. Unless something happened to Alessandrini when I wasn't. Did I blink and miss something about Alessandrini being injured? Because I don't. He didn't get injured, did he? No, I'm sorry. Now this game is making me wonder if he did get injured. Or was there two injuries? Did I miss that second injury? How did Fletcher miss that? Oh my God! Thank you. Freaking hell! Oh. That's actually, Os Campos. After her freaking. In defensive.
I did think that this would be one of the tightest games.
Of clusterfuck.
It's extraordinary, it's gone the other way.
It finally gets.
Everybody in the stadium is quite surprised by that. Because the one side has been knocking the ball about nice and crisp.
I'm not sure. What happened to Alessandrini? And when did it happen? Because
the next game, Alan?
He did not get injured. At least I didn't see him get injured.
I think this could be pretty easy.
I wasn't told of any injury.
Love the tackle.
And I didn't move him out of the team, so I don't know why.
Stephen Fletcher.
He Diaby is in. The Hoots instead of Alessandrini, he shouldn't be there.
That's safely away. And here's the header. Terrific stop. It's a corner again.
Good header. I like how Batshuayi is waiting until late on in the game when the game is 100%. And one, the 3 points are wrapped up. Now he's starting to make a contribution. Freaking Os Campos. Freaking hell, you get one goal, when all of a sudden you're trying that shit. You know, give him crap if they're having confidence in himself. Oh, but damn, I think that's having a little too much confidence in oneself.
Is going to be the goalkeeper. Yeah. Quite straightforwardly, quite simply, and he can pick the ball up. Gian Moutinho. Benjamin Mendy. He's cut out that pass. It wasn't an accident. He read the mind of the opponent. Michy Batshuayi. Now the shot.
Batshuayi. Campos is gonna come back in and is. I wanna say shot? It was a pretty poor one. It was like. It's like he was chipping it as well as lobbing, a lob pass. It was like a chip and a lob pass. Whatever it was shit.
Lassana Diarra.
And here's the shot.
Fletcher! Oh.
Fine save.
So the corner about to be taken.
Hit the post.
It's offside.
God damn it. Oh, he was offside anyway. So that should wrap it up. Nope, they took it short. Fair enough. Okay, there's the full-time whistle. I was going to say if he had
match, it was rather one-sided,
lashed it down the pitch, which he should have done, for even the slight possibility of getting a consolation goal. Oh, but no, the keeper is like, it's that 4-0 is a pretty good defeat for some reason, or I don't know why he... He didn't lash down the pitch, but it doesn't matter. The match is over, and the job is done.
Nil. Olympique de Marseille 4.
Yeah, look, he's there.
Toulouse nil. Nice.
Where?
Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the table remain Olympique.
What the hell is going on?
Points. In second, Paris Saint-Germain with 35 points.
I am extremely confused now.
Fourth, Stade Rennais with 31 points. In fifth,
oh, I don't know what to make of this. Points.
In sixth, rising up the table are Olympique Lyonnais with 23 points. In seventh, moving down are Lorient with
20. I'll say this. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button, did subscribe if you're new to the channel. We'll see if you don't miss any future content from myself. And until next time, hope you all have a very nice day.
With 11 points.
Peace.
With 13 points. Fifth bottom, Lille with 14 points.